I'd like to talk to you about the elephant in the room with respect to disorders of the brain. And that is, we don't measure the brain for the diagnosis or treatment of brain disease. There is currently no clinical indication to measure from the fundamental cell responsible for information processing in the brain, the neuron. And that's because making that measurement carries some inherent risk, and we wouldn't know what to do with the information if we collected it. This problem is unique to the brain. It's unlike any other organ in the body. We can get a pretty good understanding of how the heart works by looking at an individual cardiac myocyte. The same is true for a hepatocyte with the liver or an epidermal keratinocyte for the skin. But it is not the case for the brain. We have a fairly sophisticated understanding of how individual neurons work, but that tells us virtually nothing about how the brain controls movement, performs arithmetic, recalls memories, or elicits emotion. And that's because these various operations of the brain are not the result of any single neuron, but instead an emergent property of millions of neurons acting together in a network to give rise to the functions of the brain. There's a really good analogy to computing here. Trying to understand how the brain works by studying one neuron at a time is similar to trying to understand how your computer runs your word processing program, or browses the web, plays games, or decodes this very video that you're listening to right now by studying just one transistor out of the tens of billions that comprise a modern CPU. It's a hopeless endeavor, and that's a system that we built and understand inside out. On the other hand, the human brain is the most complex network we have ever had the privilege of studying and looking into. And while it may seem like a daunting and impossible task to unravel its mysteries, systems neuroscientists have done a remarkable job over the last couple of decades studying hundreds and now thousands of neurons simultaneously in the setting of behavior across both animal studies and human studies to form theories about how the brain might work. This is the core focus of our research group, the Brain Interfacing Laboratory, which not only records from populations of neurons, but perturbs the system to extract not only associative and correlational insight, but also a causal and mechanistic understanding of how the brain works. If we're successful, this has significant implications for brain disease, from stroke, Parkinson's, and epilepsy, to dementia, Alzheimer's, and even psychiatric disease. We are on the cusp of addressing the elephant in the room, and when we do so, we will transform the management of all brain disease. It's a really exciting time for our field, and I hope you follow along as we navigate the science and then translate those findings to medical therapies to improve the lives of the billions of people worldwide impacted by these debilitating disorders of the brain. Thanks for listening.